Okay, so if you're writing a research paper using the MLA format, first thing you want to do is you want to check your margins. They should be 1 inch all the way around. You can see by looking at the ruler that the horizontal margins are 1 inch here, and over to the right, they're also 1 inch, but you can't see the vertical. So in order to see all of them, go to File and do Page Setup, and make sure you have it on 8.5 by 11 paper and that all of the margins are 1 inch. Once those two things are right, click OK. And then when you're back at your paper, you also want to have your last name and the page number as a header. So just click once above the body of your text. It'll put your cursor in the header. We're going to start over on this one. Let's hit backspace. Type your last name, and then after it, go to Insert, Header and Page Number, and then do Page Number, and use the option that shows the 1 and the 2. So what that's saying is it's going to start numbering on the first page where you are right now, and then just go sequential after that. If you select that, you see it put in the 1, and it has a little gray background. That gray background tells you that that number is dynamic. So when you scroll down to the second page, it's going to be a 2. So Google Docs is thinking about that number and putting in the right page number on each page. That should take care of all your pages unless you actually go into one of the other headers and edit them. So try not to do that. Just let that go like that. And then you need to have this specific header. You need to have your name, your professor's name, the subject name, and then the date with the day first, so the leading zero if you need one, the month and the year. Now you also need to have your paper double spaced. If I go to this first line and I hit the down arrow, it goes all the way down to the P. So I've set this up where I'm not hitting enter twice after every line. I've told the entire document to be double spaced. So assuming you've typed everything, you need to change it. Select everything. So hold down the control key and type A so you have all your text selected. And go to the double spacing, and you'll find the double spacing up in the menus. Go to Format and Line Spacing, and then just choose Double Spacing. That'll take care of everything. And we'll go back down, and you notice the report title's first line. You have to have that centered. These are your different alignment choices. For the title, just center it. And when you get into the body of your text, you see each new paragraph is indented. In order to make sure that that is right, go up to Format and go to Align and Indent. And then let's look at your indentation options and use a special setup here where you say the first line gets a 1/2 inch and click Apply. And make sure you apply that to every paragraph in the body. So I would start with the first one, scroll down to make sure you capture all your paragraphs. And the next thing you want to make sure, let's reselect all of these paragraphs, and we want to make sure it's not justified. So you don't want this right-hand side lining up. In order to line it up, it'll put in some makeup spacing in between the words here. But we want all of this to be just the natural spacing, and when you come over to the right, it won't be even. So that's called left align. You don't want to have it on justify. For the actual text itself, let's select everything, do Control A. And the MLA specifies that it should be a readable text. But if you want to be safe, just make it Times New Roman. If you look down at the bottom, it just says Times New Roman checked. And make it 12 points. Make everything in there 12 points. It's pretty standard. And then we'll go into the Works Cited page. Okay, so if we scroll down the document to the end where the Works Cited page is, you're going to notice it's already indented, but it's not the type of indenting that we want. And before we dig into this, make sure that you can see your horizontal ruler. If you can't, go to View and just make sure that Show Ruler is checked. Now left click at the top and select all of the lines that you want for your Works Cited, and just don't select the title of the page. And now these changes that we do are just going to affect what we've highlighted. It won't affect the indent for the rest of the report. And there are two marks here on the ruler. One of them is your first line indent, and then one of them is the left indent. And for a hanging indent, we want to reverse these. So left click on the downwards pointing arrow, take that over to 1/2 inch, and then left click on the rectangle and take that back to 0. And now when you look, the first line is aligned at 0 at the edge of the margin. But the second line has the subsequent lines indented. And one thing to keep in mind here is you can't have an enter key at the end of these lines if they're supposed to be more than one line. So at the end of print, you would have used the enter key, and then docs would have known that that also does not get indented. But at the end of this line, you just use a space and you keep on typing, and then docs will know that this gets the hanging indent. So if this was three lines, you'd do the same thing. You would just type all the way. The third line would come down and still be indented. And that should be basically all. So the hanging indent is here. If you come back up to the body of your document, it's the regular indentation that we went over. And your report now has the basic formatting. So I hope that was helpful. If you liked that video and you want to see others just like it, you can subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. And don't forget to click that little bell that comes up if you want to be notified about the new videos. Thanks for watching.